नमस्कार अभिनंदन रिस्पेक्टेड एस्टीम्ड गेस्ट डायरेक्टर एचआरडीसी कोऑर्डिनेटर ऑफ द डिफरेंट प्रोग्राम डिस्टिंग्विश्ड पार्टिसिपेंट अ वेरी वार्म ग्रीटिंग एंड वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस कंबाइंड वैलिडिक्टरी सेशन फॉर थ्री डिफरेंट प्रोग्राम आई एम संजीव शर्मा असिस्टेंट डायरेक्टर एचआरडीसी जेएनयू इट गिव्स मी एन इमेंस प्लेजर एंड इंडीड अ मैटर ऑफ प्राइड and honor to host the combined valedictory session for three program. Very briefly, I will share with you that we are virtually connected 4 weeks ago in the faculty induction program. That is the 5th faculty induction program. We were virtually connected in 2 other refresher course. The first one is the refresher course in environmental studies and the second one moment of extreme pleasure to welcome the esteemed guests who are present in this combined valedictory session today to bless us with their knowledge and wisdom. We are very lucky with the presence of Honorable Vice Chancellor Jawaharlal Nehru University, New Delhi, Professor M. Jagdish Kumar sir. Welcome, sir. We are very lucky with the presence of Professor Binod Kumar Jain sir, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Tejpur University, Assam. Thank you, sir, for joining us. We have with us Professor S. C. Sharma, Director, National Assessment and Accreditation Council. And due to some urgency meeting, he is in some other meeting. So he has sent a recorded message. Thank you very much, sir. We have with us our course coordinator, Professor Ram Sagar Mishra from School of Physical Sciences, Dr. Suchi Yadav from Center for Media Studies. Both the course coordinator are for course coordinator for faculty induction program. We have with us course coordinator for environmental studies refresher course, Professor A.P. Dimri from School of Environmental Sciences, Dr. Indrani Roy Chaudhary, School of Social Sciences, Center for Study of Regional Development, and Dr. Ashwani Kumar Tiwari, School of Environmental Sciences. Welcome, ma'am, and welcome, sir. We have with us Professor Seema Batla, Center for Study of Regional Development, School of Social Sciences, and Professor Annamalai Kanal, Center for Study of Regional Development, School of Social Sciences, course coordinator for the economics. I feel great proud to say that we are indeed in this second year of online courses. And for this academic year, we have completed today 8 programs under a different component. As we all know that education is the single most important instrument for social and economic transformation. And throughout the country, as we have now more than 1,000 university and more than 42,000 colleges, with student total enrollment is 31 million. So various government program and initiative are being adopted to boost the growth of education system. Besides focusing on new education technique, such as e-learning and mass machine learning. In contemporary time, our university cannot promote an academic life in an isolation, but are required to champion reason and imagination in engagement with the wider society and its concern. So these HRDC program is also the one of these, the program which conducted to enhance the existing skill of the faculty program under different the component. So even in not only the faculty, but new strategy for the governance of education institution are also needed to promote. So this is the one very good platform where all faculty members are sharing their experience, the knowledge and idea also. And these HRDC program also allow us to meet us some brilliant mind of the country who came as resource person. So with this brief background, now I would like to invite our director HRDC, प्रोफेसर ब्रजेश कुमार पांडे सर से मैं विनम्र निवेदन करूंगा कि हमारे आज के माननीय मुख्य अतिथि महोदय सभी प्रतिभागियों और कोर्स कोऑर्डिनेटर का स्वागत एवं अपना उद्बोधन आप सबके समक्ष रखें. ओवर टू यू प्रोफेसर पांडे सर.
धन्यवाद डॉक्टर संजीव. सबको सादर नमस्कार, सबका अभिनंदन. आज जैसा कि डॉक्टर संजीव ने बताया, हमारे 3 पाठ्यक्रम पूर्ण हो रहे हैं, पर्यावरण अध्ययन तथा अर्थशास्त्र के रिफ्रेशर कोर्सेज, और ये पिछले 2 सप्ताह से संचालित हो रहे थे. जबकि जो FIP है, जो 5वां FIP है हमारी HRDC का, उसका प्रारंभ 4 सप्ताह पूर्व हुआ था। भारतीय परंपरा में इस जो कोर्सेज कोऑर्डिनेट हुए हैं उसको हम ज्ञान सत्र कहेंगे, उसकी समाप्ति पर मुझे लगता है सबके हिस्से में सबकी झोली में कुछ न कुछ नया आया होगा जिसका उपयोग विनियोग वे एक शिक्षक के रूप में और समाज के सक्रिय और प्रबुद्ध नागरिक के रूप में निश्चय ही वे सभी अपने अपने स्थानों पर कर पाएंगे, पूरे देश में और अपने इंस्टीट्यूशन के लिए कंट्रीब्यूट कर पाएंगे, ऐसी हम सबकी अपेक्षा है। मेरा दायित्व जैसा कि डॉक्टर संजीव ने बताया अतिथियों के स्वागत का है, शैक्षणिक जगत के शिखर पुरुषों का स्वागत करना जो आज हमारे बीच में है उनके प्रति एक तरह से कृतज्ञता व्यक्त करना है। हमारे मध्य में आज त्रिमूर्ति हैं, हमारी समस्त गतिविधियां जिनके निर्देशन में मार्गदर्शन में संचालित होती हैं वे हमारे माननीय कुलपति महोदय हमारे बीच में हैं, हमारे स्नेहिल दक्ष एवं दूरदर्शी कुलपति हमारे कुलगुरु प्रोफेसर एम जगदीश कुमार जी का मैं स्वागत एवं अभिनंदन करता हूं। वे हमें प्रेरणा देने के लिए न केवल HRDC को बल्कि संपूर्ण विश्वविद्यालय को वो हमेशा हमारे साथ खड़े नजर आते हैं, मैं आभार पूर्वक उनका स्वागत करता हूं। प्रोफेसर विनोद कुमार जैन, आपका हम पर विशेष अनुग्रह है, वे इसी विश्वविद्यालय के JNU के ही अंगभूत हैं और JNU का जो अकादमिक और प्रशासनिक वैशिष्ट्य है उसको साथ लेकर के उन्होंने अनेक विश्वविद्यालयों का नेतृत्व किया है, कई जगहों पर कुलपति रहे हैं, उनके सुदीर्घ अनुभव का लाभ हमें प्राप्त होगा। आपका भी सर बहुत बहुत अभिनंदन और स्वागत। NAC के सिद्धहस्त निदेशक प्रोफेसर SC शर्मा, आप बहुमुखी प्रतिभा के धनी हैं, कई विश्वविद्यालयों के कुलपति रहते हुए उन्होंने महत्वपूर्ण उपलब्धियां प्राप्त की हैं, कई निर्णय ऐसे किए हैं जो शैक्षणिक जगत के लिए बहुत ही श्रेयस्कर हैं, भारत के उच्च शिक्षण संस्थानों के मूल्यांकन का उत्तरदायित्व तो उनके पास है, मैं स्वागत करता हूं। आप सभी जानते हैं बिना पाठ्यक्रमों के जो समन्वयक हैं उनके बिना किसी भी कोर्स को संचालित करना बड़ा कठिन होता है, वो एक तरह से असंभव सा है। हमारे तीनों पाठ्यक्रमों के जो कोऑर्डिनेटर्स हैं पहले नाम ले चुके हैं, डॉक्टर संजीव, प्रोफेसर सीमा बाथला, डॉक्टर एलुमलाई कर्णन, प्रोफेसर AP डिमरी, डॉक्टर इंद्राणी राय चौधरी, डॉक्टर अश्विनी तिवारी, प्रोफेसर राम सागर मिश्र तथा सुचि यादव, वो इन सभी पाठ्यक्रमों के आधार स्तंभ रहे हैं, मैं उनका स्वागत करता हूं। उनकी सक्रियता, दक्षता, अकादमिक कौशल एवं अनुशासनपूर्ण संचालन, ये सभी मिल करके इन सारे पाठ्यक्रमों को उन्होंने गरिमा प्रदान की है, मैं सभी का कृतज्ञतापूर्वक स्वागत एवं अभिनंदन करता हूं। मेरे सहयोगी डॉक्टर संजीव शर्मा तो पूरे HRDC का सूत्र संचालन ही करते हैं, गौरव और नेहा सारी ऑनलाइन व्यवस्था करते हैं और सभी प्रतिभागियों के साथ निरंतर संवाद बनाए रखते हैं जिसके कारण से हमारे किसी भी पाठ्यक्रम में व्यवधान उत्पन्न नहीं होता, उनकी सारी शंकाओं का समाधान होता है और ओम प्रकाश जी सहित जितने भी ऑफिस के स्टाफ हैं वो सभी सहयोग करते हैं। तीनों कोर्सेज के प्रतिभागी आप सभी जानते हैं जो संपूर्ण भारतवर्ष का प्रतिनिधित्व करते हैं, उनका स्वागत करना वस्तुतः भारत के संपूर्ण बौद्धिक जगत का एकत्र स्वागत करना है। JNU के इस वर्चुअल प्लेटफॉर्म से जोड़ करके आप सबने समर्पण, नियमबद्धता एवं पारस्परिक संवाद के माध्यम से जो जीवंत वातावरण बनाया है उसके लिए आप सभी अभिनंदन के पात्र हैं। हर आयोजन, कार्यक्रम या पाठ्यक्रम उसको सभी दृष्टि से परिपूर्ण बनाए रखना या सर्वांगपूर्ण बनाए रखना, ये इसके लिए हम सभी प्रयास करते हैं, मिलकर प्रयास करते हैं, किंतु कभी कुछ न्यूनताएं रह जाती हैं तो उन पर अधिक ध्यान न दे करके मेरा आग्रह है कि जो सकारात्मक रहा उसे अपने साथ लेकर आप जाएंगे, जो कुछ भी पॉजिटिव आपने पाया है, कुछ यहाँ से सीखा है उसको अपने क्षेत्रों में लेकर के जाएंगे। हम सभी शिक्षक समाज को गढ़ने तथा उसका मानस बनाने में सबसे बड़ी भूमिका निभाते हैं, हमारी भूमिका सर्वोपरि है। हम यदि सकारात्मकता के साथ छात्रों को प्रबुद्ध कर पाते हैं, उन्हें राष्ट्र की प्रगति, विकास तथा समरस समाज के निर्माण की दिशा में प्रेरित कर पाते हैं तो कदाचित हम अपने दायित्व में सफल रहते हैं। एक ओर हमें विकसित एवं साधन संपन्न आर्थिक रूप से आत्मनिर्भर राष्ट्र के रूप में विश्व समुदाय का प्रतिनिधित्व करना है, तो दूसरी ओर अंधाधुंध विकास के कारण जो उसके साइड इफेक्ट्स हैं उसके रूप में मानव सभ्यता के लिए उत्पन्न जो संकट हैं उनसे भी हमें दो चार होना पड़ता है। प्रकृति और मनुष्य के बिगड़ते संतुलन को सुधारने को भी हम सबको अपनी प्राथमिकता में रखना है, और इसी दृष्टि से अर्थशास्त्र और एनवायरमेंटल साइंस के जो कोर्सेज संचालित हुए हैं उनका लक्ष्य इसी तरह का था। विकास के लक्ष्य की जो प्राप्ति है उसके लिए शोध, अनुसंधान और नवाचार बहुत ही आवश्यक है, और दूसरी ओर पर्यावरणीय संतुलन हेतु भी शोध और अनुसंधान आवश्यक है। एक शोधार्थी एवं अध्यापक के रूप में हमें अपनी विशेषज्ञता राष्ट्रहित एवं वैश्विक हित में निरंतर प्रमाणित करनी पड़ेगी। गुरुदक्षता का जो लक्ष्य है एक उस ओर हमारी दृष्टि निश्चित रूप से इन पाठ्यक्रमों के माध्यम से गई होगी। हमारे भीतर ज्ञान का गुरुत्व हो, नवीन शोध करने का अन्वेषण करने का गुरुत्व हो, अपने स्वयं के आचरण का गुरुत्व हो, और इन सबसे बढ़ करके देश हित के भाव का गुरुत्व हो, यही हमें गुरु के रूप में प्रतिष्ठा देगा। इस दृष्टि से हमने निश्चय ही अपने भाग को ग्रहण किया होगा, अब कुछ पाया होगा। भारतीय ज्ञान परंपरा जो सर्वसमावेशी है, सर्वस्पर्शी है, और जो खंड 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 में ज्ञान को नहीं देखती है, एक संपूर्ण रूप में देखती है, इसी भावभूमि का निर्देश हम सब में रहे, यही हम सबकी अपेक्षा है, आकांक्षा है। आप सबका पुनः आभार, अभिनंदन, सबको प्रणाम।
धन्यवाद सर, आपका आभार और अभिनंदन आपके मार्गदर्शन के लिए। I would share with the all esteemed guests and participant that during these courses, like in professor course, we have more than 72-hour teaching, and in faculty induction program, 108-hour teaching. So more than 170 resource person have delivered their talk, not only from India, but from the abroad, representing various institutions and organization. And many of the vice chancellor and the head of the institution have delivered the talk. During these courses, we have also organized two workshops. The one is on internalization of curriculum that was coordinated by Professor Soni. And another one is big data analysis and hands-on stata. On the request of the participant. So in continuation with the proceeding, now I would like to invite the course coordinator for faculty induction program, Professor Ram Sagar Mishra and Dr. Suchi Yadav. Please share the brief report of the course. Over to you, Professor okay. Mishra and Dr.
Thank Suchi. Thank you, Dr. Sharma, and respected Vice Chancellor, Professor M. Jagdish Kumar, and our esteemed guest, Professor V.K. Jain, Professor S.C. Sharma. I would like to extend my sincere thanks for joining us in today's valedictory session of Faculty Induction 5. And the brief reports about this Faculty Induction program, actually there are 38 participants has actively participated in this Faculty Induction program 5. And they were belonging to the 25 different institutions. And if you consider the Indian states, they were from almost 11 different states of India. So very diverse group of participants who joined the Faculty Induction Program 5. And there were almost 36 institutions where we approached for the resource person. And two of them were from abroad, like Professor Daya Tusu and Mr. Dhruva Jayashankar, who speak from the United States of America. And in this faculty induction program, a diverse class of lectures were given, and they were from history, they were from geography, from media, from science. So very like vibrant lectures has been delivered in this faculty induction program. And also I hope our participants who joined from different states, the almost 11 states, they must got benefited the course by the lectures which has been given by our expert. And I'm sure they will utilize the knowledge which has been imparted on them for their teaching purposes. And this is how this particular faculty induction program was named like Guru Dakshata. So they have got some Dakshata and collectively in terms of academic, as far as the academic is concerned. So with this, am thankful to Professor Brijesh Pandey and Dr. Sanjeev Sharma for giving me this opportunity to act as a coordinator for this faculty induction program 5. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. And now I would like to request Dr. Suchi Yadav. So we are highly appreciated, both the coordinator and Dr. Yadav. You both have spent too much time, like 30 days with participant also. And sometimes you are not in the class, so participant just sending the message that madam is not there or sir is not there. So over to you, Dr. Yadav. Madam, you are not audible. Please unmute your audio. Thank you.
Thank you, Sanjeevji. Thank you so much. Let me begin by welcoming all the esteemed guests. Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Jagdish Kumarji, Honorable Vice Chancellor Despur University Assam, Professor V.K. Jainji, Honorable Director NAC, Professor S.C. Sharmaji, Director HRDC Brijesh Kumarji, Assistant Director Dr. Sanjeev Sharmaji, fellow course coordinators, HRDC staff, and dear participants. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome you all to the combined valedictory program of UGC HRDC. I extend my heartfelt gratitude to Vice Chancellor Sir and the HRDC Director Sir to have provided me this opportunity to coordinate a month-long program, 5th Faculty Induction Program of JNU HRDC called Guru Dakshita. As the word Guru Dakshita suggests, this program was designed to help the newly recruited faculty from across the country to enhance their capabilities and exposure with a learner-centric approach. Discerning the nuances of effective teaching, both as a process of learning and as a method of knowledge creation. I hereby take this opportunity to present a brief report on the faculty induction program. Professor Ram Sagar Mishra has just given you an overview. We shall get into some of the details. Esteemed guests, as we all know, that learning is a lifelong exercise. So we tried to put together a galaxy of national and international experts related to higher education in order to sensitize and motivate the faculty towards understanding the policy and praxis of higher education in India, with a special emphasis to National Education Policy 2020. The focus of the program was also to help the participants discern and discuss the policy in a holistic manner, to help them implement curriculum reforms in the context of interdisciplinarity and applied approaches to knowledge. The course was designed with an emphasis to faculty development from a psychosocial perspective in 4 quadrants: personal, instructional, organizational, and professional. All of this to encourage and inculcate thinking in terms of achieving academic integrity and quality research capabilities for contributing effectively as teachers towards nation building. Nearly 80 resource persons, comprising mostly serving and former vice chancellors of several universities, such as Mahatma Gandhi International Hindi University, Vardha, Central Tribal University of Andhra Pradesh, Mizoram Central University, University of Himachal, and National Law School, Bangalore. We were also honored to have the presence of Professor Bhushan Patwardhanji, former Vice Chairman of UGC, to engage in an insightful discussion on higher education and nation building. It gives me immense pleasure to mention that resource persons were a mix of academicians, bureaucrats, policymakers, and even journalists. Head of the departments, institutional heads of directors from government organizations such as UGC, InfluNet, Inter-University Accelerator Center, New Delhi, the National Institute of Technical Teachers Training Research, Institute of Lifelong Learning, All India Institute of Medical Sciences, and Library Sciences across universities engaged constructively on topics related to research in bioinformatics, bioentrepreneurship, artificial intelligence, robotics, online content creation, etc. Experts in psychology and social sciences covered a range of issues such as stress, friendliness, inclusion, diversity, and sustainable development goals. Above all, we also had major stress on academic values and academic integrity. For topics like role of academic research in policy making, we were obliged by Sri Dhruv Jayashankar, executive head of Observer Research Foundation America, who joined us from Washington, D.C. For a national perspective, Sri Ashutosh Bhatnagar of the Jammu Kashmir Studies Center, New Delhi, interacted closely with the participants. Experts of national and international communications, such as Professor Daya Kishan Tusu from Hong Kong University, Professor K.G. Suresh from Makhal Rajchaturvedi University, and Professor Sanjay Dwivedi from INC New Delhi also graced the occasion. Beyond the lectures and discussions, guests, the participants also undertook workshops on data handling, quantitative research, and internationalization of curriculum. Esteemed guests, JNU also takes lead as far as innovative research projects are concerned. Participants, therefore, were privileged to attend workshops conducted by faculty of international repute from JNU on the EU-funded Rishi project, resources related to internationalization of higher education institutions of India. JNU, under the leadership of Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Jagdish Kumar, is one of the leading partners in this project. Assessment is always a part of any course. Therefore, for the last 2 days, all participants demonstrated their month-long learning in the form of project work, discussed thoroughly by the evaluators appointed through a rigorous evaluation process. With participants and nearly 40 of them from across the country and nearly 80 resource persons, these 4 weeks were an intellectually stimulating experience even for the coordinators like me to be able to have witnessed live demonstrations of the Bharatiya culture of Sambhav throughout the course. My sincere thanks hereby to the Vice Chancellor and HRDC JNU Director for this opportunity and my heartfelt gratitude to the team HRDC, Dr. Sanjeev Sharma, Gaurav and Neha for their endless support to the coordinators. Last but not the least, it was an honor to have engaged with faculty participants, which were an enthusiastic group of academicians who exhibited a yearning to learn even at this stage. And I'm sure they will go back home with a lot of leadership qualities and thought-provoking suggestions. Congratulations to all successful, but congratulations to all for a successful completion of the course. And thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Yadav. So may I request to our Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, you have meeting.
Okay. Thank you.
So may I request to address the participants, sir. Thank you.
So let me share with all the... So let me share a few thoughts with the participants of this program. I can see that there are nearly 120 who have joined this. First of all, welcome to Professor V.K. Jain, whom I have known for several years. And you also mentioned that the participants are from different parts of the country. Now, whenever I join programs such as this, and when I see, you know, colleagues like you who are teachers and who are in the teaching profession, I always feel happy and proud to be part of this profession. You know, sometimes we may think because of the noise all around, we may not recognize the importance of a teacher. We may think that, well, it is like any other job, but it is not, because as a teacher, every time when you enter the classroom or when you are interacting with your students outside the classroom, you are shaping the thinking and the thought process of these youngsters who will, you know, continue to grow in their education and ultimately become agents of change in the society. So every time when you enter the classroom, when you are taking your lecture, I think we need to remind ourselves that the 50 minutes lecture that we are giving on that day is an important contribution that we are making in shaping the minds of future citizens of our country. And that is very, very important because the respect that we get from our students and the kind of changes that we will bring in their thinking process depends on a couple of things. For example, first, the foremost thing is, of course, to have deep knowledge in whichever subject that you are teaching. And the most important part is the ability to communicate this with our students. Otherwise, why should the students come to your classroom unless the students themselves feel that they gain by attending your So there are two things that we need to keep in our mind. Try to develop deep knowledge, become a great scholar in your own chosen area of expertise, and then take the communication, important component. How do you introduce the topic to your students when you enter the classroom? How do you get excitement in their minds so that they can keep focused on what you're teaching in the classroom? Every time I walk into my classroom, in the corridor, before I enter into the classroom, I'm constantly thinking, what is the first word that I say to my students? What is the first sentence that I will say to my students? Because enter the class, only the speech that you give, it is your body language. When you are looking eye to eye, do you smile? So what emotions you show when the students react a particular way to what you are saying, how do you receive that and make them more comfortable to ask even inconvenient questions? Or, you know, the student should be able to ask questions which they themselves may think is a foolish question. By the way, many of the questions that the students ask in the classroom, they are not foolish questions. Some of my best papers came from the questions that the students have asked in the classroom. So as teachers, therefore, it is very, very important that when we walk into the classroom, you know, we need to be compassionate, we need to be kind to the students. And sometimes when we enter our teaching, you know, as a lecturer, as an assistant professor, when we think about what is my role as a teacher in the classroom, what answer in my mind? As a teacher, what is my responsibility in the classroom? When I speak to some young teachers, they say, well, to teach well, to be you know, a great teacher in the classroom. But often, you know, when we recollect our own great teachers when we were students, one thing they did was that they always tried their best to make us good learners. So even in the National Education Policy, for example, we talk about student-centric teaching, not teacher-centric teaching. It is not enough for us to go and give a great lecture in the classroom and come out of the classroom and think that, oh, I delivered a great lecture. That's not enough. Unless the students are motivated to become good learners, we will be failing in our responsibility as teachers. So if we want to make our students great learners, then what is that we need to do in our classroom? How can we make them great learners? I often tell the following thing to my students in the classroom. In the first lecture itself, I tell them that if you want to become a great learner, you need to do four things. And this is what the modern cognitive science tells. And this is what was told by Adi Shankara hundreds of years ago. Adi Shankara said, if you want to become a good learner, you need to do four things. Patanam, Mananam, Chintanam, and Sankirtanam. Pathanam, you have to study. Mananam, whatever you study, whatever you learn, you need to remember it. Chintanam, you need to critically think about it. And Sankirtanam, you need to repeat the whole thing. So as teachers, whatever intellectual activities that we conduct in our classroom should promote these four activities. Pathanam, Mananam, Chintanam, and Sankirtanam. And only by making our students lifelong learners that we can bring the change that we would like to bring in our society. You know, there are two courses that are conducted out of this HRDC program, and one is the environmental studies, and the second one is the economic studies. But if you look at the major challenges that the human societies are facing today, one is the frequent failure of the economic systems, and the other one is the degradation of the environment. Now, these two are leading to one very, very important challenge that all of us have to deal with, that is the increasing inequality from region to region, from country to country, from person to person. So unless we understand the economic systems better, unless we understand how to protect our environment, it is going to affect our lives too. And we will not be able to reduce these inequalities that are unfortunately across the globe. So I am very, very hopeful that the inputs that you have received from this training program will make you more alert to the kind of challenges that our societies are facing. And in turn, when you go back to your students, you will not only teach only the technical aspects of the subjects, whether it is economics or environmental studies, but you will also from time to time, somehow by bringing some discussions into your teaching, you sensitize your students to become socially responsible. And that is what as teachers, all of us have to do, whether you are teaching chemical engineering or electrical engineering or economics or biology or sociology, constantly we need to bring back our students to be attentive, to become socially responsible individuals. And I'm sure that with the course that you have undergone here, when you go back to your respective the thoughts that I have shared with you in your mind and become great teachers, and in the process make your students, transform your students into great learners. So with those comments, I would like to conclude here with congratulations and my appreciation to all the teachers who have participated in this training program, and also particularly the coordinators who have put a lot of backstage efforts in bringing these resource persons together and in organizing this whole event. I'm sure they must have spent hours and hours. So I would like to thank them and appreciate their efforts in conducting this program. So with those comments, I would like to conclude here, and thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. Our deep sense of gratitude to you, sir. And thank you so much for your support, encouragement, and motivation. And I do hope that it would be motivate, inspire, and encourage to all our participants. Thank you very much, sir, for sparing your valuable time. Now, I'd like to proceed further, and I would like to invite the course coordinator for the Refresher Course of Environmental Studies, Professor A.P. Dimri, Dr. Indrani Rai Chaudhary, or Ashwani Ji. Please share your course brief report. Dr. Indrani Rai Chaudhary or Professor Dimri, over to you.
Thank you, Dr. Sanjeev. Respected Professor Kumar, Professor Jan, Professor Sharma, Professor Pandey, my colleagues in JNU, and my participants across. The course which we coordinated is on the environmental studies. Environment is very concurrent in the present time. We have recently IPCC AR6 report, And after 1 month time, we have COP26. This is the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. And hence, in the recent decades, we have seen there are various changes on the environmental spheres are coming, be it air pollution, be it climate change, be it dancing precipitation pattern from the Indian summer monsoon, snow. There are length of disasters also have occurred, flooding, we have a landslide. So we have in this program roughly 37 participants from all pan-Indian universities, degree colleges, and simultaneously we have roughly 32 resource persons to deliver on this environmental strategy program. We have tried to make a very good bridging between environment and economics, because if you have a disaster, you have an economy involved. If you have a dam construction, you have economy involved. If you have flooding. So the point is the how the disaster and economic balances are made, number one. Number two point, what we tried in this program is to have a kind of bridging between social scientists and natural scientists. Researches of science remains in the papers, research papers, how to bring that into the ground and have the social intake into the concurrent research. That is a very important need of this hour of our nation. And simultaneously, how to lead and extend and explain the complexities, what is nonlinear dynamical system, what is allowed and what is not allowed. In view of this, keeping in mind, we have chosen a 6 group of people each and given them a very distinct plan, project plan, under which they themselves did a good job. And these are the very concurrent issues. Number one is water, climate, extremes, agriculture, society, and health. These are the 6 projects we have assigned to this set of 6 people out of the list. And based on this program, they have provided very important inputs in the project. And as far as the resource person is concerned, we have seen that the climate in the past, paleoclimate, climate and organizational diversity, how the warming signal and the diversity is linked together, relationship with various global to regional scale phenomena leading to environment over the nation, Himalaya. And simultaneously, we also include certain kind of methods, actually, numerical methods, how to crunch the data, how the methods are used for the purpose of various time series, various data series, various numbers. And then importantly, I would like to add, what are the air quality issues? What are the recent advances in the air quality issues? Glacial lake outburst floods, land lake outburst floods. So there are various environmental issues were covered using the experts in the availability on the online mode. And they have given extensive feedback mechanism. Also, this feedback will be sharing with the HRDC, which will be probably strengthening the HRDC's ideas in the future, whatever the participants has given to us. Another important point is the policy planning for governance and holding. How these kind of discussion, whatever we are talking, how these discussions, findings of research at the various level of international to national level can be converted to the policy planning of the governance. That's very, very important that whatever we are talking, how this is going down to the policy planning in different ministries, different core groups, different understanding of the system where the execution of, we have a very successful model of the tropical cyclone forecast where the policy planning is effectively done. Similarly, this policy planning can be thought of in the sense of floods, in sense of climate change, and recently the heat waves we have seen, and particularly our memory is very short. If you remember, this particular year has broken all one-day record. In winter, one-day minimum, in one-day precipitation maxima, one-day heat wave. So this is a very peculiar situation. We are going in a way where the non-linearity of the system has to be understood. Why I'm telling all these that we have shared this with all the participants, what are the future directions they will have, because with the request to them that they will go to their respective places, respective colleges, and how they spread these kind of thing to the colleges. So with this brief word, I thank Professor Bridges, Professor Sanjeev for giving me this opportunity. And I surely thank my co-coordinator, Professor Indrani and Professor Aswani for all together helping me in this interview. Thank you very much, Professor Sanjeev. Over to you, please.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your hard working or coordinating this course or accepting our invitation. Now, I would like to request Dr. Indrani Rai Chaudhary, please share your views on related to your course. Over to you, madam.
Thank you so much, Professor Sanjeev, Honorable Vice Chancellor Professor Jagdish Kumar, Professor Vinod Kumar Jain, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Tejpur University, Assam, Professor S.C. Sharma, Director of NAC, Professor Rajesh Pandey, Dr. Sanjeev Sharma, all my respected colleagues, respected coordinators, HRDC staffs, dear participants. It's my pleasure to just exchange a very hearty welcome to all of you and present briefly about this fifth refresher course in environmental studies, which was scheduled during September 2020 and is ending over today. The course is attended by 36 participants across India, and HRDC has taken special attention in maintaining the regional representativeness. Regarding this participants' profile, it is very much diversified. So we have across science, we have participants across science and humanities and social science disciplines. Across science, we have participants from a diverse background, say physics, chemistry, maths, geology, zoology, environmental science, biochemistry, and so on. Similarly, across humanities and social science, we have participants from history, geography, political science, philosophy, economics, social work, religion, literature, etc. So the course is designed with a focus on climate and extreme weather events. So as Professor Dimri already mentioned, that environment is all pervading. So environment is getting a very scarce resource nowadays, and the trade-off, as we extract more and more environmental resources, there is a huge trade-off in terms of various manifestations like pollutions, climate change, various kinds of land degradations, water contaminations. All these things are happening at a rampant scale. So obviously, with the core focus of climate and extreme weather events, quite a number of sessions are organized with a focus on the central theme. However, we do arrange many sessions which are indirectly catering to the core in a broader perspective. Some lectures are also kept with an intention to impart the understanding on the quantification tools and the very implications for policy interventions. Moreover, we made earnest effort to keep the rigor of the multidisciplinarity in the selections of the topics as well as the speakers. We have 33 academic sessions, and the resource persons are selected from all premier academic institutes of India. So apart from our JNU colleagues who have generously rendered their support, we have successfully drawn distinguished academicians from various institutes and universities like IIT Delhi, IIT Kharagpur, IIT Roorkee, Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, Indian Meteorological Department, National Institute of Hydrology, NIT Rourkela, University of Delhi. In fact, various departments of the University of Delhi, like Department of Geology, Botany, Delhi School of Economics, are all involved for taking these responsibilities. Institute of Economic Growth, Delhi School of Advanced Studies are among the most the institutes which actually we sent invitations to the faculties. So let me just briefly mention some of the topics which will give the idea about the very diversified canvas which we tried to capture through this program. So these are basically this abrupt climate change in the recent past and the warnings for the future, recent advances in air quality modeling and forecasting, modeling of extreme weather events, carbon negative technology and combating of climate change, climate and organismal diversity in space and time, sustainable development and environmental pollution, management of coastal vulnerabilities and adaptations, economics of ecological restorations, buds and noise, basics of the hydrology and eco-hydrological modeling, environmental cost-benefit analysis using Excel, human behavior, well-being, and the complex problems of sustainability, agricultural input subsidies and natural resource degradations, food securities and natural resource management, air quality and health, urban growth and water sustainabilities. So these are basically few of the 33 technical and academic sessions which we have organized. We do hope that the academic sessions have provoked a lot of thoughtfulness and have given the participants a broader perspectives and enrichment towards the pertinent issues of environmental studies. I convey my heartfelt thanks to HRDC assigning me the responsibilities of coordinating the program. And apart from the interactions with the participants as well as the experts, this course has also given me enough exposure to listening to many of the eminent speakers and also exposed me to the enormous scope of learning and appreciating the strength of interdisciplinarity of environmental issues. However, I do admit that given the wide diversity of the subject specialization of our participants, it is not possible to do justice to fulfill their requirements for all. But we do made a very sincere effort to keep the topical issues in our course design. We do hope that the end of the course, the participants will be able to take away the very essence of the environmental issues with an improved understanding of the integrated functioning of the ecosystem, the trade-offs which exist, and the interlinkages with respect to ecosystem, economy, society, and well-being. So I extend my heartfelt thanks to HRDC, and I wish to convey my best wishes to all the participants for their future endeavor. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Indrani Rai Chaudhary, for sharing the brief report of the Refresher Course Environmental Studies. We have also third coordinator, Dr. Ashwani. He may not share his view as he shared with me. So we are also thankful to Dr. Ashwani, very young, dynamic, and hardworking faculty of the School of Environmental Sciences. Now I would like to request Professor Seema Batla, course coordinator for the Refresher Course Economics, kindly share the brief report of your course. Over to you, madam.
Thanks, Dr. Sanjeev. Respected Professor Kumar, Honorable Vice Chancellor JNU, Professor Jain, Professor Pandey, Dr. Sharma, dear colleagues and friends. Dr. Kanan and I have coordinated the 54th Refresher Course in Economics. I must say that it has been a very enriching experience for both of us. I know over the years, the participation from various states have always, participants from various states have always looked forward to visiting JNU for the course. Now it's done in an online mode, which had its own challenges instead of the preferred physical mode. So I must appreciate and congratulate the HRDC team, Dr. Sanjeev Sharma, Gaurav Ji, Neha, and other staff for a smooth conduct of the course. As we all know that there have been serious concerns on overhauling our health system and addressing the social and economic impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic. Through this pressure course, we have tried to delve into some of these pressing issues and other developmental issues in a coherent manner. We invited experts on industry, environment, taxation, monetary and fiscal policy, migration of labor, health and nutrition, poverty and unemployment, and agriculture reforms. The experts were from Delhi and many other states. The subjective experts, you know, provided important insights into each aspect, which were very valuable not only for the participants but also for us to undertake research and teach with policy perspectives in mind. The sessions, I would say, were very interactive and stimulating, though tiring towards the end of the day. Many times it happened that we used to get engrossed in discussion and Gaurav Ji had to request in the chat box to end the session. All in all, we were glad to see that the course, even when done through Zoom meetings, turned out to be a great success. The participants have given a few suggestions to further strengthen the course, which we will include in a brief report to be submitted to the HRDC. Our sincere thanks to the eminent resource persons and the evaluators for sparing their valuable time. I request Dr. Kanan to share his experience.
Thank you, Professor Seema. Good afternoon to everyone, respected dignitaries and colleagues. So I would like to add a few more points to what Professor Seema Bhatla has just mentioned. So we had 32 participants from different states, drawn from different states, working in different colleges and the universities. And it is worth to mention that 69%, more than 60% of the participants are the women faculty members from different colleges and the universities. And this made actually the program very interactive and lively, and the kind of discussion that they had, it was really fruitful. Although it was online mode, but we could observe the kind of very good bonhomie among them and the very good interactions to in terms of sharing their views and ideas on wide-ranging issues, feeding into this kind of, the summary report of the lectures that submitted every day. And overall, about 32 lectures delivered by the resource persons drawn from reputed research institutions and the universities. Now, apart from the topics that Professor Seema Bhatla has mentioned, we also covered some emerging areas, some emerging topics in the field of economics, including the big data analysis, impact evaluation studies, and health economics, and then some aspects of, more importantly, machine learning in the application of machine learning in the field of social science research, and some aspects of computable general equilibrium analysis. In fact, the participants were given the real world data to work with to generate some kind of simulation, simulation exercises, where one could observe output shock in a particular sector, how affects the output from the all other sectors. In fact, this kind of exercises we found very useful in the current scenario where the pandemic is still at large, that how output in a particular sector will have, how output shock in a particular sector will have an economy-wide impact. So overall, I also shared with Professor Seema Bhatla that the experience of coordinating this particular edition of a refresher course in economics was highly satisfactory. And we are really satisfied for two reasons. One is the active involvement of the participants, without which we would not have been successful in completing this refresher course. And thanks to all the participants of the 54th refresher course in economics for their lively and active participation in all kinds of discussions. And second, to the HRDC. HRDC gave us a complete independence to design the course and the conduct the lectures the way that we wanted. And therefore, we would like to place on record our appreciation to the HRDC, particularly to Professor Brajesh Kumar Pandey and Dr. Sanjeev Sharma, encouraging us the way that we should design the course and then conduct it. So we would like to thank, I joined with Professor Seema to thanking you, HRDC and the HRDC team and all the participants for making this program successful. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Seema
Bhatla. Thank you.
Anand, for accepting our invitation and coordinating this course. Now I am purposely elated to take an opportunity to invite and briefly introduce Honorable Vice Chancellor of the Tejpur University, Professor Vinod Kumar Jain sir. He is our JNU professor from the School of Environmental Sciences. So before joining Tejpur University, Professor Jain was the Vice Chancellor of the Dune University. And Professor Jain has started his academic career from the United Kingdom as a faculty, then IIT Delhi. And he has contributed a lot in the field of magnetized plasma, beam plasma interaction, linear and nonlinear effect, environmental issues, specifically on energy, noise, and air pollution. So we heartily welcome you, sir, and we request you to address our participant. Over to you, Professor Jain, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Sharma. Professor Jagdish Kumar, the Vice Chancellor of JNU, Professor Pandey, the Director UGC, HRDC, JNU, Dr. Sharma, and all the esteemed coordinators of the three programs and the participants. First, let me congratulate all the participants for having successfully completed their respective courses. And my sincere sense of, I would like to express my sincere sense of appreciation to all the coordinators, you know, for organizing lectures with such diverse canvas of topics under the sun, you know, as far as the environmental issues are concerned, or this refresher course of economics, whatever topics were mentioned by the esteemed coordinators. And I'm sure all the participants must have found these two refresher courses extremely enriching. Friends, you would attest to the fact that much as these refresher courses and the induction program, they are useful as part of your service conditions or for your professional growth, but they are also in some way an instrument to revitalize and reinvent your research interests. And it is in the context of the new education policy, wherein the role of a teacher is not so envious anymore. You know, you are supposed to produce human capital in your respective institutions. Hello, am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yeah. So, you know, when the NEP is trying to, you know, overhaul the entire system with the main objective of producing the human resource or the human capital, which is globally competitive, equipped with the requisite skill sets. At the same time, they have the capacity and the ability to address the developmental imperatives of the country. I think the role of the teacher becomes even more crucial. For a start, the teachers have to update and upskill themselves first before they can impart the requisite domain knowledge or the skill sets, which the Honorable Vice Chancellor was also alluding to. It is in this context that I find organizing this valedictory function of the environmental science as well as the economics together, because I do see that there is this organic connect between these two disciplines, and they are so interrelated with each other, and they both, as has been mentioned, they both relate to not only the developmental imperatives of the country, but also in the larger context to the general well-being, you know, of the people, and in a country where there's so much asymmetry as far as the wealth distribution is concerned. In fact, the Vice Chancellor did make a mention of that too. So I think one can not underemphasize the importance of these two disciplines in the contemporary context. May I also just amplify on this point? But what this essentially means is that the human capital not only is having this specialized domain knowledge, but it's also equipped with certain contemporary skill sets to use resources as well as the economic capital efficiently, optimally, so that not only that you build on this economic capital for the benefit of the country, but also take care of the natural or so-called environmental capital too. So I think in the contemporary context, this interconnect between the environment, that is the natural capital, the human capital, the economic capital, I think the linkages between these three capitals is so crucial for the overall progress of the country. Professor Dimri did talk about this COP26, which is in not too distant future, is going to be held in Glasgow. And I'm sure that conference is also going to give some direction to the businesses and to the economics or economy of the different countries, because that's where it is possible that all the countries, the member states of the UN would be required to undertake much deeper commitments for the reduction of the carbon emissions. And therefore the issues of finance, the issue of, your shift or this transformation from the carbon intensive growth or carbon intensive economy to the carbon neutral economy is going to be, some direction will be given in that conference. Having said that, the country, as you all know, the current government is also, looking at the higher educational institutions to provide leadership as far as the developmental issues in the country are concerned. And that's why the entire overhauling of the higher education system, which is sought to be achieved in the NEP, it means that the educational institutions would have to gear up with regard to in some sense disruptive transformations, both in terms of teaching and learning and the way we impart knowledge to our students. And I would like to take a couple of minutes on this. So say, you introduce a academic program, let's say 4-year bachelor's program. So what the institutions would be required to do would be that for each year, you define what would be your domain.
Sir, we are not able to hear you. I think there may be
skill sets in the third year and at the end of the academic program. Because the very success of the multiple entry and multiple exit program would depend on that what kind of bouquet of the courses you would prescribe for your students across various disciplines, including those in environmental science and in economics. That what are the set of courses which you would offer, let's say in the first year, when the student wants to leave the undergraduate program midway after 1 year, and he wants to get out of the system for whatever compelling reasons, he should be able to get a certificate. Now, certificate means that he has a certain level of proficiency in that discipline. Likewise, after second year, if a person wants to leave and he gets a diploma instead of a degree, then that person should also be equipped with certain skill sets which qualify him as a diploma holder with a certain additional skill sets. And at the end of the third year or the fourth year, then the person has the complete set of skills to earn a bachelor's academic degree. But one of the challenges would also be for the faculty. So this is not only in terms of revisiting the academic architecture of your entire curriculum, but it is also important that how to evaluate the skill sets in each semester or in each year. So that is also going to be a bit of a challenge, because at present, in the case of vocational courses, yes, there are set guidelines. You have national skill qualification framework. And there you have very well-defined qualification packs for a certificate course, for a diploma course, or for a academic degree. But in the case of general education, you are going to have to integrate these skill components into your academic architecture of your undergraduate or postgraduate program. And to then suggest evaluation methods or assessment methods for evaluating the skill component, how much a candidate or a student has assimilated these skills, you would require either the help of the sector councils or you would require some help from the skilled universities, or you will have to develop this in-house expertise within the higher education system across all the universities, whether they are private or the government-owned institutions, including the central university. So the challenge is going to be quite huge, because I personally do not think that the system as of now, even in central universities, is equipped to deal with this assessment or evaluation of the skill component. So this is going to be a major challenge. But with regard to the issues of the research, you know, how to, you know, what kind of research we have to undertake. Both these disciplines, to my mind, whether it is environmental science or economics, they afford you this luxury of, you know, either doing basic research or applied research, or in some sense, you know, the research which is relevant to the society, you can call it problem solving research. And this is the emphasis of the current government, that they are going to encourage the big ticket funding as far as the R&D spending is concerned in this country is going to be in the areas of problem solving research. And it is in this context that this National Research Foundation, I'm sure most of you must have heard of it. And as and when the call for such call for proposals by NRF are sought, then you know, the call is given by NRF, you know, seeking proposals to address some of these burning issues facing our country. I think it's younger people or younger faculty like you who should be prepared to participate in that call and submit your proposal. So I'm sure some of you must have got together, and because I was listening to the reports of some of the coordinators, and it was mentioned that five or six of you were, you know, some groups were formed, and so there is a certain amount of, you know, already some collegiality which has been encouraged in these refresher courses. So these teachers can get together and undertake projects which are of multidisciplinary nature and which are of problem solving nature. So I'm sure that the refresher courses the participants have found very useful, and they have enhanced your abilities and capacities to do better, both in teaching and learning, as well as in your research pursuits. So I would like to end here and thank Professor Pandey and Dr. Sharma and some of my erstwhile colleagues, Professor Dimri and others, you know, who conducted these refresher courses and the induction programs. So my sincere sense of gratitude to the HRDC, JNU, for giving me this opportunity to be with you this afternoon. So thank you, Dr. Sharma. Thank you, Dr. Pandey. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, sir. And our heartfelt gratitude to you. And we are truly delighted with your presence. And thanks very much for sharing your views. We are honored to listen to you, sir. And you have rightly highlighted that the need-based research or the academic challenges and the role of academicians for the society and evenly for the science. Thanks again, sir, for accepting our invitation and sparing your valuable time. Now we are proceeding further. This is a time for the sharing experience from the participant side. So they can share the experience on behalf of all the participants. So generally what we do that we may not be able to invite each and every participant. So generally we are inviting the name through like the mail or the message. And after that, what we do that through our lottery system, we generally select one male participant and female participant so that they can represent the whole of their other participant also. Although we have interaction during morning session also with the course coordinator also. So from the faculty induction program, I would like to invite Dr. Novita Priyadarshini. And I request all the participants, please introduce with your institutions and please share very briefly. You have 2 minutes because we are already running out of the time. So over to you, Dr. Navodita Priyadarshini.
Sure, sir. Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon. Myself, Dr. Navodita Priyadarshini, Assistant Professor, University Department of Zoology, TMVU, Bhagalpur, Bihar. And today I will be sharing my experience with the faculty induction program organized by HRDC JNU. First, I would like to thank whole HRDC JNU family for giving me this opportunity to become a part of it and share my experience. Since first day, and our first speaker, Professor Chintamani Mahapatra, Professor T.V. Kattimani, Professor Daya Thussu, to our last day speakers, Dr. Mallika Kumar, Dr. Bhaswati Das, all the resource persons were excellent and masters of their own field. Their lectures were thought-provoking and led to a fruitful questions and answers and discussion sessions, which culminated into a better vision and refined perspective of the subject. The lecture were multidisciplinary, which helped me and all the participants to understand about the opportunities and challenges for higher education in India as well as in global context. It also helped us to learn about the different aspects of pedagogy, objectives and learning, outcome-based education, details of research publications, writing of projects, different funding agencies all across the India. We also get benefited by knowing about the upcoming trends of online teaching learning platforms like MOOCs, SWAM, InfliNet, etc., applications of different ICT tools in pedagogy. The program also helped us to know about the details of administrative structures, roles and responsibilities of different national agencies like MHRD, UGC, NAC, NIRF, AICT, NCTE, etc. Also got to brief know-how of NEP 2020 and its expected outcome in near future. We also learned about the different sustainable goals which are achieved and yet to be achieved. We also learned of how to manage stress, professional ethics, conduct, code, and being sensitized about the inclusive learning where we should show empathy to the persons of special needs. Me, on behalf of all the participants, can say that this faculty induction program, which named Guru Dakshita, live up to its name and true senses. And so at last, I would like to extend my sincere gratitude to Director Professor Brajesh Kumar Pandey sir, Assistant Director Dr. Sanjeev Kumar Sharma sir, Course Coordinator Professor Ram Sagar Mishra sir, Dr. Suchi Yadav ma'am, and technical team of HRDC JNU for providing us the platform to learn and evolve. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Priyadarshini, for sharing your experience. And we on HRDC will definitely ensure you that whatever the feedback we have received, and in every courses we try to improve ourselves also. So like, your feedback is very, very important for our improvement also. Now I would like to invite Dr. Sumit to share your experience. Over to you, Dr. Sumit, from the faculty induction program.
Thank you Sanjeev ji, thank you so much. As my colleague Navodita has already covered most of the areas, so I'll be concentrating more on the cognitive and the emotional aspects. So as far as the FIP 5 is concerned, since I'm speaking on behalf of everyone, I can, with a lot of surety, I can say that first of all, putting in a very simple sentence, we have learned a lot. There is no doubt about it. Secondly, as far as the idea of interdisciplinarity is concerned, this FIP 5 has been a very big booster, as well as it has shown us a new path as to how to approach this very idea of interdisciplinarity. The third thing, which I personally believe, is that as far as the FIP 5 is concerned specifically, as Navodita has rightly mentioned, so many faculties from across the country and few from abroad also, they have given us a new perspective how to approach our own subjects as well as the vast area of social science, in my case, and obviously in my colleague's case, the idea of life sciences. Fourthly, the JNU family, I have been a part of the JNU family while I was studying for 9 years. And it's basically ghar bapsi, you can say, for me in a way. And I believe that those people who have not studied in JNU, now they are also the part of the JNU family, like all of us. And one thing I have to say, the sheer professionality, the professionalism I have seen in the last 22 days is beyond description. I mean, Suchi Madam, sir is there, Gaurav ji, Neha ji behind the scenes, so smooth. We have so, and informality complemented by a sense of belonging, that is the best combination one can have. So that is what I at least found in FIP5, and I'm sure everybody, all of my friends and colleagues have found that. And we have learned a lot, taking back a lot of things, a lot of takeaways. And I hope JNU, my alma mater, will give me another opportunity in the future also to gain some more knowledge from my refresher course. So on behalf of everybody, thank you so much. And thank you everyone, everybody, in one word, the JNU family, thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Sumit, for sharing your experience. And you know, that's the, I want to share with you that maybe the JNU refresher course or HRDC programs are totally different. Sometimes we maybe, or the course coordinator may be hard, like maybe very rigorous also. So this is only to maintain the quality of the HRDC JNU, because this is one of the prestigious, like the organization in our country. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Pradeep Sarkar from the professor course, Environmental Studies. Kindly share your experience on behalf of all the participants. Over to you, Dr. Sarkar.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon to all of you, respected Director Professor Brijesh Kumar Pandey and Honorable VC of JNU, Assistant Director Sanjeev Kumar Sharma, Coordinator Professor A.P. Dimli, and Professor Gaurav Pandey, and Professor Indrani Rai Choudhury, Professor Enamul Kannan, and Shima Bathu. A very good afternoon and warm welcome to all of you to this valedictory session of refresher course, which was inaugurated on 20th September 2021. Professor Pandey, Director HRDC, welcomed the participant and explained the significance of refresher course in details, and explained the significance in this inaugural address, explained the transmission of higher education in the recent past, and the need for teachers to enhance the quality and the skill of transfer to the students. Refresher course is a retraining in a subject we previously learned into refresh our memory and make sure our knowledge is up to date. According to Swami Vivekananda, arise, awake, and stop not until the goal is reached. I, Dr. Pradeep Sarkar, on behalf of participant, I would like to express my sincere appreciation and gratitude to all the moderators, presenters, discussions, and participants who very active and frank discussion, which I think have made this refresher course very fruitful. It improve our professional skills also. It's my privilege to extend my sincere thanks to HRDC JNU and to all for giving me an opportunity to express my experience during this program. I extend a really hearty thanks to all renowned speakers who have updated contents and more impressive motivational and enthusiastic, who spared time from their busy schedule to grace the program. We had an opportunity to hear a speaker's thought, and this will surely be going to in our future life, thoughts of different resource person have enlightened our mind and have shown as a new horizon. I am immensely thankful to SDC for the reports, ideas, and elegance of explanation of everything. I need to mention my deepest sense of appreciation. I also further thank to all the technical staffs and non-technical staffs for their enormous cooperation with us. I especially mention Professor and Professor Gautam Pandey for their enormous cooperation with us. Once again, I thank you all. Namaskar.
Thank you, Dr. Sarkar, for sharing your experience. Now, I would like to invite Dr. Sumana Bhattacharya for sharing your experience from the courses on behalf of your participant. Over to you, madam.
Thank you, sir. Good evening, all of you. Respected Honorable Vice Chancellor, sir, Director, HRDC JNU, coordinators of environmental studies as well as economics, and the technical staff. Vice Chancellor, sir, Tejpur University, Vinod Kumar Jain, sir, AC Sharma, sir, Sanjeev Sharma, sir. First of all, I would like to thank organizers, especially Director of Academic Staff College, JNU, coordinators, Professor A.P. Dimri, Professor Indrani Roy Choudhury, Dr. Oshini Kuban Tiwari, and the technical team, especially Gaurav sir and Neha ma'am, for successfully completion of refresher course in environmental studies on virtual platform during this global pandemic. The normal rhythm of livelihood of the people, exclusively world's economy, socio-cultural compatibility, academic atmosphere, and moreover, our regular lifestyle has been incredibly disrupted due to the fatal novel coronavirus. In this situation, JNU offered such excellent refresher course that we have really refreshed and enriched through thought-provoking lectures by many scientists, scholars, and professors. JNU means knowledge hub, debate platform, and an ideal place for new thinking. It provides brilliant academic environment for students, scholars, and teachers. Previously, I went there for orientation program and I learned many things. Here, professors are very dynamic, polite, down to earth, and very friendly. Few things are truly attracted me, like HRDC Center, hostel, canteen, central library, especially Peacock, Nilgai, Porcupine, Sarathi Rock Cave, etc. I have not enough words to explain the beauty of these campuses, as well as the academic atmosphere. This year, I have got excellent lectures, but missed the campus beauty. Once again, I extend my sincere gratitude and thank to director, coordinators, and professor for organizing such excellent refresher course. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for sharing your experience. Now, I would like to invite Dr. S. Ramakrishnan from the refresher course Economics. Kindly share your views, Dr. Ramakrishnan.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Good evening, all of you. I'm very happy to share my views for this 54th refresher course in economics on behalf of the participants. The day one started with a great lecture in the title of Teaching Economics, and till today, total 32 sessions were conducted with the great resource persons. These technical sessions, we learned many things. The session, all the sessions were informative, interactive, and what I can say, it's thought-provoking. We learned many things from all the resource persons. But here, I would like to say, we learned, all participants, my the 54th economics refresher course, we learned one thing. We have discussed today morning. We learned one thing from our course coordinators, Professor Seema Batla, Professor Elumalai Kannan. We learned from them the specific aspect is punctuality. They kept clear on the time management. Really, we learn, and we are all like, definitely we will inculcate in our colleges, in our programs as well. So it's very much appreciated, because collecting this many of resource persons and conducting this kind of long period of courses, it's a very difficult task. And we are not meeting like in direct. We are all somewhere else. So calling them to manage, and that is what I'm telling. The both our coordinators very keen on time. Professor Yerumalai Kannan sir is very strict with the time, and our even Seema ma'am also. But Seema Batla ma'am little we can feel free as a friend. So really, as a faculty member, we need to learn this kind of aspects. So I am very thankful to the HRDC JNU from the beginning, like. Vice Chancellor Jagadish sir, Director Prajesh Kumar Pandey sir, and Assistant Director Sanjeev Sharma sir, and special thanks to the technical team, Gaurav ji, salam for your work, and Miss Nega. Really, the time also they both attentively given the timing, schedule, everything. So very thankful to the HRDC and our course coordinators, Professor Seema Batla, Professor Elumalai Kannan sir. So thank you all of you. We really learned many things. Thank you once again.
Thank you, Dr. Ramakrishnan, for sharing your experience. Now we have our last participant, Dr. Sumedha Pandey. Over to you, madam, and please share your experience on behalf of all the participants. Over to you, Dr.
Pandey. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. I would first of all like to welcome all the respected dignitaries. Thank you for giving us all this opportunity to be a part of JNU refresher course, 54th refresher course in economics. Although this is a formal sharing of experience, but I may not be so formal. The day we were shared the schedule of the week one of the 54th refresher course, I guess some 5 to 6 days back from the start of the refresher course, I think all had some or the other questions and confusions regarding what all lectures will be delivered, how will it be delivered, how friendly will be our course coordinators, our co-participants and everything. But the day the lectures restarted, all were very friendly. Seema ma'am, Kannan sir, both were very punctual in their appearance in every session. They were a mix of both the things. They were both lenient as well as strict at certain places, and that was needful, I guess. And somewhere we felt that when the course schedule was shared and all the guidelines that were mentioned over there, somewhere we were a bit worried, like, will it be very hectic? Will it be very cut-to-cut sessions and everything? But all went very smoothly. And I feel in this 2 weeks of refresher course, everyone has learned many aspects of economics, not only economics, but as a teacher, one thing that we have learned is to listen, because we have forgot to listen. We are only delivering lectures to our students, but we have forgot the habit of listening. So I feel now as a teacher, apart from what we have learned in economics, we have learned much more as what we can improve being a teacher, being a person, not only from our speakers, but also from our both coordinators who were very friendly. So on behalf of all the participants, I am heartiest thankful to both the coordinators, to the team of JNU, and definitely the technical team experts, Gaurav ji, Neha ma'am, and all that were working behind the scenes, because I don't remember even a single day when we were not shared the session links and details timely. Every day in the fourth session, we got all the details, and he was always there. Gaurav ji was always there for any technical help whenever we needed. So this kind of support and help, I did not expect it, but that is a very good thing. So this was my first experience with JNU, and it was a wonderful experience. Whatever I had heard about JNU, I could feel much more better than in the first-hand experience. So thank you everyone for giving us this opportunity to be a part of JNU family. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Pandey, for sharing your experience. And we had a very great time having you all since last 4 weeks. And I hope that in future, we will also meet when this corona pandemic is over. So you are also very welcome to join our HRDC program. There are different programs conducting under different component. So now we are just going to the end of this program. Dr. Ashish Sharma, director of NAC. So due to some urgency, he is traveling right now. So they have shared the video. And I request our technical team to share the video. Before that, I would like to briefly introduce Professor Sharma. Professor Sharma is an educationist, researcher, administrative, technocrat, musician, and man with a missionary zeal to serve the society with devotion and sincerity. He is a director at NAC. And he is also honorary distinguished professor in the Center for Energy, Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati. Earlier, he was vice chancellor of Chhattisgarh Swami Vivekananda Technical University and vice chancellor of Tumkur University, Karnataka. Now I would like to request Gaurabji, please play the video. And participate.
Relevance to contemporary education scenario. Namaskar to all of you. Respected professor Jagdish Kumar ji, Vice Chancellor Jawaharlal Nehru University, Professor Brij Kumar Pandey ji, Director UGC HRDC JNU, Professor Vinod Kumar Jain ji, Vice Chancellor Tejpur University Assam, Dr. Sanjeev Sharma, Assistant Director UGC HRDC JNU Course Coordinators, Distinguished Professors, Deans, Directors, Heads of the departments, professors and students who are attending this webinar through online, dignitaries, media representatives, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great pleasure to be here to deliver combined valedictory address on this auspicious occasion of 5th Faculty Induction Program, 5th Refresher Course in Environmental Studies and 54th Refresher Course in Economics. I deem it my privilege to address this August gathering through e-mode digital platform. Education is a psychological process which concentrates on mental refinement. It is never-ending voyage from aviveka to viveka by unraveling inner core in totality of an individual's personality. Unless the medium through which it is transmitted to the mind of a student is perfect, it will not achieve its realm. Here, the mechanism of mind of a pupil must be thoroughly observed and understood by a teacher before he tries to transcend the mind of the former, and this Shreyo Marg takes both teacher and the taught in the joyful journey of sadhana. Today I would like to throw glimpses on the ancient system of education, its inherent philosophy, relevance to the present scenario by taking leaf from few verses of our ancient scriptures which extensively propagated ethical perspective. What we practice today as modern parameters or criteria in higher education and its institutions through institutionalized statutory regulatory authorities are deep-rooted in our heritage, culture and ethos, which have evolved robust knowledge practices since time immemorial. It may be observed and it is evident that our society itself played effective and proactive role of institutionalized regulatory authorities as we have today. From this, it is evident that any evaluation of educational institutions based on ethical practices or its contributions to the society, from the ethical point of view, it is good to have evolved a system from the social background which had wider scope and impact on the society rather than institutionalized framework. In our knowledge system, the methodology was the physical, intellectual, emotional, moral, active and spiritual, fitted all at once and beautifully to the conditions, culminating in the development of personality. Adequate knowledge of the world, the subtle relationship between a student and a teacher considered as nucleus part of the education system as sacrosanct. The Mahakulapatis or Acharyas of the Vishwavidyalayas expected from the teaching faculty to be ideal exemplars in the aspects of dignity of the behavior, restriction in their conduct purely to academic activities, unselfish motive, perfection in their subjects, and many more. Whenever a student approaches the Gurukula, it was the bounden duty and regarded as imperative on the part of the preceptor to teach. He could not refuse even an unqualified student, though there may be no prospects, whatever the amount of honorarium from the poverty-stricken student. On the contrary, the teacher was expected to arrange for the boarding, lodging and clothes of his students in case they were very poor. In fact, there is a Subhashita. Sambatsaroshite Shishye Guru Jnanamardishyam Harate Dishkritam Tasya Shishyasya Dasato Guruhu Kurma Purana. Recognizing as binding duty is part of the preceptor, Kurma Purana exhort that the preceptor shall impart knowledge to his pupil within a year of his coming, failing which all the sins of the pupil were to be transferred to him. The second chapter of Mandukopanishad advocates the ethical responsibility of a teacher as follows. Tasmai sa vidvanu pasannaya sammika prashanta chittaya shamanvitaya yenaksharam purusham veda satyam provachtam tattato brahma vidyam. Meaning, a learned teacher with all honesty shall impart pristine knowledge to a deserving and eligible student who comes to him seeking knowledge. Chandogya Upanishad states that if a teacher capriciously withholds instructions from his properly qualified students, even God will become annoyed for the deeds of the preceptor. The best social practices are always reflected in the contemporary literature of a civilization. Our Sanskrit literature are the concrete documents of anthropology with abundant instances evaluating and showcasing the ethical practices that prevailed in every phase. Kalidasa, the Kavikula Guru, in his play Malavi, Malavi Kagni Mitra, has reflected those ideals in one of the characters enunciated his views against the commercialization of education. Labda spadosmit vivada virosti tikshamanasya parena nindam yasya gamaha kevala jivikayetam jnanapanyam vanijam vadanti malavikadu mitra kalidasa. Meaning, a man who fights shy of a contest because he is well provided in life and puts up with an insult from another and whose learning is a mere means of livelihood. People call him a merchant trading in knowledge. The Ashtanga Hridaya underlines for the holistic perspective of students, the medical experts of those times mention that 6 months period of waiting should be regarded as sufficient in the case of medical students to enable the teacher to find out their seriousness and intellectual caliber. Every minute aspect of learning process were based on ethical practices as evident in the following verses. Acharya sarva jeshtasu loka eva hi dhimantaha anu kuryattameva vato laukikarte parikshakaha ashtanga hridaya dinacharya adhyaya. Meaning, for an intellect person, the whole world is a guide bar teacher. Therefore, follow the world as an evaluator of the performance of the worldly affairs. And sukarteh sarva bhutanam matah sarvah pravattaya pravattaya sukamchana विना धर्मात्मा धर्मो परो भवेत् अष्टांग हृदय दिनचर्या अध्ययन. ऑल द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ ह्यूमन बीइंग्स आर मेंट फॉर हैप्पीनेस ओनली. सच हैप्पीनेस विल नॉट बी हैपन विदाउट धर्म आर राइट एथिकल कॉन्डक्ट. देयरफॉर वन मस्ट ऑलवेज परस्यू विथ राइट कॉन्डक्ट. Apart from elaborating about the qualities of a doctor as Dakshah, Tirthath, Shastra, Shastrastho, Drishta, Karma, Shuchir Bishak, means he should be disciplined, having detailed knowledge about diseases and treatment with practical experience and cleanliness. In our system of education, the teacher had to be good psychologist and not regard teaching as a kind of business or barter with the students. The unwritten code of conduct which was practiced during ancient times have reverberated in several maxims. Nyayavalli, Hitopadesha, Subhashita Sangraha, etc., which not only criticized the human greed but also created awareness amongst the parents to be cautious of such pseudo-preceptors. Thus, education being a fundamental component of human development, its interface with sustainable development was well established. Guruvo bhavaha santi shishya vittapaharakaha guruvo viralaha santi shishya Hitapaharaha. There are teachers in abundance who will swindle money from the students, but it is a very rare to get pious teachers who can relieve the agony of the pupils. The exigency of present day is not philosophy or religion in the academic sense of the term, but ability to think rightly. If we subtly observe the disorder of the age is not absence of philosophy, but wrong thinking and its narcissism has crept into our education system. However, it is difficult to define right thinking, and it cannot be denied that it is the goal of aspirations of every generation. But wrong thing is the attitude of the mind, where the false is mistaken for the true, and it is also a deep-rooted prejudice which is hard to eradicate. Therefore, some efforts have to be made in tackling the problem in its core. That is by laying emphasis for multidimensional ethical practices in evaluation practices of academic institutions and also education system. Even an individual or an institution or even organized system, the more we drift from the ethical consciousness and higher values, the more rules we invite. The dire need of the hour is presentation of truth in a proper forum, fitted to the particular stage in which human consciousness finds itself and suitably adaptable in a given situation of human mind and psychology is that no consciousness cannot reject the truth as they are two faces of a coin. Methods of instructions may differ, but the truth does not vary. If the present day education format has not succeeded in progressive contribution to the society as well as reaching its aspirations, it is because of the wrong methods adopted in stuffing the student's mind with information that cannot be easily digested. Moreover, education is not accumulation of information, but assimilation of reality by degrees. When we as educators, teachers, facilitators, including parents, forget this fundamental truth behind the educational process, inevitably education becomes a mockery and meaningless exploration. For a teacher, educational career is holy pursuit. Its sacredness should not be profaned by indulgence to the subhuman urges. In the process of imparting education, the intellectual, emotional and active sides of human nature receive adequate attention. In the teaching learning process, the relation between the inner and outer realities, the physical nature of a child, the physical and social nature of the environment should be harmoniously maintained at every stage. Though new areas of knowledge emerged, changes become inevitable. However, today is our collective responsibility that the modern education shall intimately knit itself with the achievements, aspirations and outlooks of the society at large. When we forget this fundamental truth behind the educational process, education becomes a travesty and life may be a meaningless adventure. Yukti yuktam pacho graham baladapi shukadapi anyat trinamivatyajyam apyattam padma janmanam. If it is relevant and meaningful, we should respectfully hear to the wise words. It does not matter even if it has come through a small boy or a parrot. On the other hand, if it is not worth, we may totally reject such words as trash, even if the same has come through Brahman. Padma Janmana means Brahman. It may not be out of place if I mention this made that during the inauguration of Indian Institute in England at Oxford University, which was inaugurated by Prince of Wales, the words in the commemorative inscription on the inaugural plaque were as here under: Ishanu Kampaya Nityam Arya Vidya Mahiyatam Aryavartanya Vimyeshcha Vito Maitri Vivardhatam. By the grace of Almighty, we let the Indian knowledge system gain its eternal reverence and the harmonious relationship between India and deeply sustain further. This reflects the relevance of our education system in the modern times. Today, in our onus to maintain the synergy amongst the stakeholders of education, to keep the spirit of true education alive, and our system of education needs planned revamp. Sharing the ancient academic practices as intelligence, precise execution to achieve success, and in future we have to turn the success into template. Now, ultimately, what is this education? Where are we leading to? Chandrasekharendra Sri 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 Chandrasekharendra Saraswati of Kanchi Math at the end. He says, Maitrim Bhajatam Akila Vrijetrim Atmava Deva Paranapi Pashyat Yudham Tyajata Spardham Tyajata Tyajata Pare Shramama Shramanam. This song Bharat Ratna M.S. Subbulakshmi sang at the United Nations Assembly and at the end to sum up whatever knowledge we have. Even Shankaracharya also, he says in the Guru Arashtaka and Sutra Bhashyas and so many of his works, ultimately today in the future we have to turn the success into a template. The education should flow like this into success into template. I once again express my heartfelt thanks to the authorities of Jawaharlal Nehru University for inviting me for this event. Dhanyavad, Namaste.
Thank you very much for Professor Sharma for sharing his message to this recorded video. Now we have come to the end of this memorable combined valedictory sessions for three HRDC program. But I would like to underline here that this is not end. This is the beginning of the new relations, the beginning of your new research group, the beginning of new academic work. I have few announcements before I propose a vote of thanks. I hope you all participants have received your relieving order during the valedictory session. You may please submit that relieving order in your concerned institutions and you can join your duty from tomorrow onward. I would also share with you that we will try to send you by the first week your soft copy through online your certificate. And we will also send the hard copy. HRDC JNU is the only HRDC in India, those who are giving the hard copy of the certificate also. So by within the next 15 days, you will get your the hard copy of your certificate, the address you have submitted the last day through the Google form. And we may not be offer you the tea and the coffee. So sometime whenever I interact with you during this course, so I always say that please accept my the virtual tea or the coffee. Many of you, those who have attended earlier our HRDC program, they definitely miss the green, beautiful HRDC campus. Huge wildlife is here and very friendly, interacting with the student and evenly very human friendly, these wildlife. So I welcome you all in future, whenever you may come for HRDC program or for your any visit, academic visit for Delhi, please visit our JNU. So you are alumni of JNU now after attending this course. So with these words, now it is my sincere responsibility to propose a vote of thanks on behalf of the organizer, HRDC JNU. First of all, we express our sincere gratitude to Professor Vinod Kumar Jain sir, our esteemed guest for today, this for valedictory session. We are very thankful to you, sir, and be highly honored by your presence, sir, for sparing your valuable time and accepting our invitation. We are also thankful to our Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor M. Jagdish Kumar, sir. Whatever we are conducting online, these courses, only due to his motivation and support, we are able to conduct all these programs. Thank you very much, sir, for your support, encouragement, and motivation to conduct all these academic programs successfully. We are also thankful to Professor S. C. Sharma, although he may not be able to join physically, but he has sent a recorded message. Thank you very much, sir. I would like to highlight here that no course can be complete or no refresher course can take shape without the hard working of the coordinators. It was due to their dedication and enthusiasm, their determination and commendable hard work which made this day a huge success. I thank all the coordinators of all these three refresher courses. There is a long list. I may not announce the name of the each and everyone, but I thank again for accepting our invitation to all the course coordinators. Thank you very much, all the course coordinators. We highly appreciated the effort of the coordinator of all three courses for arranging highly experienced and diverse resource person who are authority in their respective subject. Thanks again, course coordinator. This is only due to you that we all have a smiling face today. We would also like to acknowledge our esteemed source person who took their time out of their busy schedule and showered us with their pearl of wisdom and knowledge. We are truly humbled for all of them. All the resource person, whether they are joined from India or the different part corner of the globe. We are extremely grateful to our valuable, disciplined participant. It would not be possible without your participation, patiently listening, and active interaction during these courses. Thank you very much. I hope whatever you have learned here, you will definitely carry you through and share with your faculty colleagues, students, so that the knowledge you have gained will definitely transfer and promote to other faculty member and the students. On behalf of the HRDC, we also thankful to all your HOD, head of the organization, because without their nomination or recommendation, you may not be able to attend. You may have seen 40 participants have joined the courses, but anyhow, at last only 36, though maybe not permitted by their organization. So thanks to all your head of the institution and organization. On behalf of the HRDC, JNU, we sincerely promise you that in the coming course, we will incorporate your suggestion and we will come up with more innovative idea to nourish the coming participant with some new and innovative ideas and knowledge. So whatever the feedback we have collected from you through your course coordinator or through our feedback form, we will definitely accept it. These all, if there may be the sum of the weaknesses or the mistake, then we will try to accept these or challenging and we will come up with some other the innovative idea. We promise you that whatever we have promised you on the first day, that we will provide you the best. And I hope that we have fulfilled your expectations and we have tried our level best. Finally, let me thank our director HRDC, Professor Brajesh Pandey, and all our colleagues of the JNU, especially Director CIS and the team for providing continuous support for the internet. I think we have not disconnected anywhere in between and we have not missed any of the lecture. So we thanks to our all CIS team. And the last but not least, there are many persons, those who are working behind the curtain. We have a very small team in HRDC, but all are very hardworking, very responsible, and I think the evidence is in front of you. Be heartily thankful to Gaurav ji, be heartily thankful to Neha ji, and you know that Gaurav is handling the three computer, three screen, in addition to one more computer on which he is working for sending all messages. So it is not easy task to handling four computers at a time. And evenly replying the message and everything, sharing attendance. The same way, Madam Arora is there, Om Prakash ji is there, and there are other members, those who may not be familiar with their evenly the name. So thank you, and this is only due to their. I request you that please give him a great apology to all the team of HRDC. And they are actually the backbone of all these, the courses. Now I have acknowledged again all resource person, coordinator once again, and at the last, I would like to congratulate to you for successfully completion of these courses. Thank you very much. Subh Sandhya, good evening. And with the permission of the director HRDC, I would like to request our technical team, please end the meeting. We have taken your 28 minutes more. So please bear with us and please apologize us. Thank you very much. Namaste. Namaskar.
Big hands to Dr. Sanjeev.
Thank you, sir.